myself Anu Chabda. Many of you have requested to see my garden. So today I thought let me give a quick tour of my garden. Where, in what section, how I have arranged my garden. So all my things are easily accessible to me. So just start the tour. So this is the first thing. I keep telling everyone, Jeevamrita or Amrit Jal, you can say, it's always ready with me. This is my bioenzyme and banana peel fertilizer. Okay, this is cow urine, always handy. Now come here, these are my portulaca, marigold. Yes, these are hanging plants, succulents, easy to care. Now here you come, yesterday only I had put the cutting of bit leaf. This is pepper, vanilla, all these are my succulents. These are dahlia, succulents, different succulents. I've just kept it whenever I need. I keep taking them for my terrarium settings. So these are adeniums, those are cactuses, this is the vanilla. Here you can have a look, see how big it is. Yes, now another 2 to 3 months I think it will start flowering. That time I'll make a separate video and I'll show it to you. Now this is my compost, which is almost ready. So I've just kept it aside. This is the banana leaves. Love to have food on bananas on weekends. So this is canna. This is your Malabar spinach. Okay. In this canna I have yellow and red, two varieties. These are all my ornamentals. Dragia, your just have a look. That is sunflower. And a few varieties I have, gulmohar, those are the roadside big trees. These here are my water plants. Now where we are standing right now is the area where I do not get too much of sunlight. So I get only morning 2 to 3 hours of sunlight. So afternoon times and noon times too much is not there, only the early morning sunlight I get little. So I make sure that I keep here such plants which are little shade loving plants. And they do really good. You can see not a single pest attack is there and they all look lush green. So it's really nice. Here also you can see this. This is in Hindi we say Draupadi Jade. That is also there. Here you see canna is there. Yeah, all these are there. Here my saplings are there. Here dhania is happening. These are all vegetable saplings waiting for their transplanting. This is coriander, my cabbage, mint, all these chrysanthemums cuttings. Another a week or 10 days I'll be transplanting them to a bigger pot. Here are all the mints, garlic chives, onion chives. These are the basil. Now come here. These are all the tree variety flowers. This is your jasmine. Come. The main part is this. This I have made a separate room. The speciality of this room that it gets a very nice filtered sunlight and it's little cooler compared to the other areas of my terrace. So the requirement of few things which is the same, the filtered sunlight, cooler temperature, less of water in case it's raining. So all these things I have combined and I have made this use, you can say, ideally this place is used for my saplings, my seedlings, my you can say growing microgreens. Here you can come, you can see the greens. And in short I can say this is an ICU for all my plants, because whenever I feel they are in the stress or they are in a delicate condition, or sometimes I have been out station and after coming I see they are not any of the plants which are not doing that well, so temporarily I shift them here, because here it is a controlled atmosphere so they can revive really fast. Okay, so here you can see all these, if you can have a look, it's here turmeric saplings. Okay, so here the sunlight is good, so let them grow a little, later I'll transplant your microgreens and all. The best part here is you have to see is my set up for aerobic composting. Okay, so instead of one bin, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and one more is there, 6. Okay, so 6 bins I have. So every day, whenever I put my kitchen waste, I make sure that I mix my coco peat or dry leaves or whatever dry material, your cardboard, whatever you want to mix, I mix it properly before adding it to the pot. I mix it, I put it in the pot, and then again I cover it with little of the dries, whatever you have, and then keep it aside. The main thing, what difference it makes is, every day I don't put my kitchen waste in the same bin. Suppose Monday I have put in this, Tuesday, Wednesday, like that I do. So by the time the turn of the first one comes, the content, what it has gone inside the last week, in that it is already 50 to 60% dried. So I never had the problem of having compost too wet, or maggots coming, or too many flies coming, because it generally happens if more moisture is there. And in my case, I never felt that. And one more thing is, because it's an earthen pot, so moisture generally gets evaporated. Apart from that also, if sometimes more moisture is there, if you can see underneath, all I have kept one small plates. Okay, so those plates, some lichen gets collected if more moisture is there. That weekly once I check and then dilute it and give it to my plant. That's a very nutritional rich liquid what you obtain from your bins. Okay, now come here. This is my orchid section. As you all know, orchids love filtered sunlight, moisture, little humidity. So this, everything is there here. So I have kept orchids here. Down I have kept all the ferns, bromeliads, this fern, and other that side also I have kept all the bromeliads, ferns, African violet. So all this maintain too much of moisture, and from the top filtered sunlight is coming. So I think they are doing really well, and I don't care much because the atmosphere, like in jungle, how they have, they survived all their own. So they don't need much of my attention. And here are my seed trays. So all whatever seeds I sow, initially I cover, as I tell every time you people, and once the saplings have started growing, I transfer them in out inside the, this, and I in a bigger pot. One more thing I wanted to show you, among all my pots are raised, and below I have made a stand so that the water does not get collected and my terrace is dry. Still further, I have kept one trays below that, so that in case excess water is there in my pots, that gets collected down in those trays, because all that water, what it comes out from my pot, it has so much of nutrition, because every time we keep giving Jivamrita or other nutrition to our plants, so that's get collected in those trays. So whenever I'm free, I dilute that and then give it to the other plant, so nothing gets wasted, and it's a kind of recycling the water also. Okay, now here is my section, because this area I get nice sunlight till this time around 3 to 4 from the morning, it will be there in this area. So all my creepers, all my vegetables I have put, especially the creepers, and you can see the stakes I have added to all my vegetables. And make sure whenever you give staking, once they reach to some height, after that I have given a horizontal support. So I don't want my creepers to keep going vertically. It has to be horizontally. Why? That I'll be taking in my different sessions when we'll cover each vegetable. So that will be easier. Now these are my flowers, my sweet potatoes, chilies, that's a cotton plant. And this is tomatoes, cherry tomatoes. You can see how nice they are growing. Yeah, now this time if you turn, you can see the bitter gourd plant. Now all my plants, I generally don't keep my pots empty. Once I have transplanted, I make sure the soil is covered with the other pots. So it acts as a mulching also, and it saves water also. And whatever the nutrition I give it to these pots, definitely it goes to the other pots. So in the same nutrition, everything is taken care of. And if you see the plant here, minimum 3 to 4 plants I'm growing together. This is your bitter gourd, your pumpkin flowers, you can see it's coming here. Another few days I can show you the fruits also. So it's pumpkin and your bleeding heart. that plant is also there. So together again, after reaching to some height, I am directing them to the horizontal way. So you can see everywhere viticulture are there. So that is one thing. And this is my favorite session here only. This is the favorite place, I can say, where I keep taking yours sessions. So whenever I am free, I sit here, I write, read. My kids, they love to enjoy sitting here. And this is something which I feel little spiritual thing of my garden, and it connects you to the garden. So I really love this place. This is something, if you see, you feel like a nursery kind of a thing. Yeah, I wanted to give that effect only, because I never like any plant kept aside in one corner of the terrace. I have noticed personally, when they are kept together in a cluster and they are grouped well, they really do well. They take care of each other very well, and because of the moisture, when they are together, because plants, they don't need water as such, what I have observed. They are very happy with the moisture only. So if you keep in such a way, so weekly once, or sometimes not even weekly once, I water them. So then also they are really lush. The growth is really nice, fresh. They look so vibrant. See the growth of the flowers and all. So it's really nice. So make sure you group them together. And here I have kept the plants which do not like too much of sunlight, frequent sunlight. Here I have the betel leaf also. So that is also a moss stick I have given. So it's taking the support of that. Once it will grow here, I'll put some moss stick here so it can go grow further. Same this way you can grow money plant also. And these are the things here. If you see, this section is my ginger, turmeric, arrowroot, because this section also I get a very good sunlight, so it's growing really well and they don't need me much. And these are the seeds I have sown for radish and all. It still takes some time. If you see this side here, I have, as I told you earlier also, I never grow a single plant. Here you have Malabar spinach, your this is bridal bouquet, your passion fruit, here, you see, such a nice flower. Okay, so a few fruits are also there up that we can't see. Once it will grow, I'll show you. So here all these are passion fruit flowers. And down, if you see, here also see one more passion fruit flower is there. How nice. And then these are your mulberry. Birds love to eat mulberries. They keep coming to my garden to have these mulberries. And this side, if you come, this is all my vegetable section. Your ondalika, your sweet potatoes, your brinjal, tomatoes. This is chickpea, your bougainvillea. This is rodpatre, like an ajwain. And there you can see when a bird is making its nest. So I've seen from the eggs till the bird stage, kids coming out of their shell and flying here and there in my garden. It was lovely. So all this pomegranate, this is jamun. There we have rangoon creeper also. Right now it's not blooming. Once it will bloom, we'll take a shoot of that also. This is your plumeria. Plumeria I have in my terrace almost 5 varieties. So gradually I'll show you the videos of that. That here also, this side you can see one plumeria is there. Here also one plumeria is there. Here you can see your Shankhapushpi growing with your passion fruit. And this section, again, it's a vegetable section. That's what every time I tell you, you have to plan your garden depending on the sunlight. When you are planning for vegetables and fruits, make sure you keep it in a place where you get the maximum sunlight. Now this section and this section, I get maximum sunlight. So all my vegetables and fruits are in this section. This section, I get sunlight only on the top part, and down part only for few hours I get the sunlight. So I have made sure the plants which does not like too much of sun in their root part, but they want their top to be in the sun and feet in cold. So those kind of a plant I have planted here. Because of the wall, too much sunlight they do not receive here. So that's where they are doing really well. And these are again my flower section, because every time I tell, if you want to plant for a vegetable garden, flowers is must. Go for local varieties of flowers, whichever grows really well in your area. But flowers are must every time for each and every vegetable. Very difficult for us to do hand pollination. So make sure that your garden should be of everything, starting from your vegetable to ornamental to flowers. And you get a space. Not only you come to your garden to just water or taking care of the plants, still you should have some space. You have to sit, admire, observe, and you want to be with them. So you can listen to your songs, you yourself, if you are a good singer, or even if you are not a good singer, you feel like singing, talking to them. So you should have some space where you can sit leisurely, look at them and talk to them, so they understand that yeah, you are spending time with them. Just watering and giving nutrition is not the thing what your plant need. They need you. So make sure this is a very good journey, and you can really do good, and one day you people will have a two huge, bigger and more systematic garden than mine. Wishing you all the best. Thank you for joining me in my terrace tour. Thank you. Bye-bye. Keep watching.